lit by Mag.
Yep. And over on IG, we have C or Luo handling the Razor. We've got Faith on the Earthshaker, Chuan on the Skywrath Mage, Ferrari 430 on the Dragon Knight, and YYF going to be handling Nature's Prophet as they make an early invasion down into the Radiant Jungle.
I always like Ferrari's Dragon Knight with the white hair and everything. It's a very special one that not many players use. Enigma, got to get scouted out there, and as a result... Yes, as a result, will not get caught. Gets one whip. But apart from that, nothing else. Once again, we see a safe lane Razor Boots first. That's always nice to see. Really effective. And yeah, they want to... Tap some wards into the jungle here. So, Faith, gonna get a sentry ward down on the Enigma's big camp. And they have one deeper in to the Radiant Jungle. So Enigma gonna be shut down the same way Puppy was in the last game. And we'll see what happens here. Ferrari gonna be missing his mid block though.
And Empire think that IG have been a little bit cheekier than they have been with the ward spots, so we'll see what ends up happening. Always wonder if I can end up converting one of these treants to begin things, so...
Might as well.
Yeah, really, why not? And it's going to prevent the creep wave being pulled around by it as well, so nicely done there. The one thing for Empire, they have a lot of counter push. They've got Midnight Pulse, they've got Shockwave, that's all fine, but the only split push that they have is Silent on the Mirana, and that could prove to be a problem, because to break out of 5-man death balls, not only do you need counter push, you also need to force the enemy team into making a decision. If they're just sitting right in front of your tower and you're standing on the other side, then you're not progressing your situation at all.
Well, you can out-deathball them, which is what Empire is doing. They're gonna pick 3 big teamfight ultimates and try and out-deathball your IG deathball, but the good thing about it is they ban Shaman, so there will be no wards on the front lines, there's no Death Prophet that can do long-range chipping on that tower, so I think Empire, if they play the laning right, if they play their cards right, they could technically get brought into the mid game and try and fight it out with their many ultimates and just shuffle between the cooldowns. We often have the problem with Void only having his Chronosphere, but now we have RP, we have Black Hole all thrown into the mix as well, and Always Wanna Fly having some problems due to this Observer Ward not getting scouted by that sentry, and he knows it's, oh man, it's just sad.
Yeah, the Observer Ward's not being spotted, the sentry is in the trees, so he's not going to be able to find it, and neither sentry has hit this Observer. They're both right on the very edge, yeah, which is super unfortunate.
And of course, RNGesus gives you the Mud Golems.
Yeah, and he'll probably go back and check this replay as well and be like, God damn it, I can't believe that, that I missed a ward
really
like
hitting
that.
Hard.
Yeah, the Sentry Ward nerfs have proved to be extremely relevant in a lot of these games.
Yeah, alright, so Mag actually gonna stack some Ancients since he can't do anything else. Might as well. Chuan gonna secure top rune for his mid laner, but instead Vanskor will find an Invis, so lucky him. I don't think they can get any kills with a Disruption, but we'll see. Ferrari might get skewered into a bad spot. He doesn't have Dragon Tail to save himself as well. But still, I think it's pretty tough to actually hope for something like that.
Vanskor is looking for the courier.
Oh, that's good. Bye bye, Pudgy.
Dire's courier has been killed. I
like how he flips around now. That's such a sad, sad sight. So, rip in pieces. Ferrari will not get his bottle. That is a lane one indeed.
And a 1,000 early game gold stocked up on that courier as well. That was. This is going to be a really big problem for Ferrari. And. We'll have to see, I guess that's going to be the edge to resolution. Normally this is a really boring matchup. Both heroes just bottle crow, both heroes just spam the wave, and it basically just comes down to support rotations or lucky runes. But with that kind of, well, with that kind of lucky rune, with the invis for Vanskor, then that's going to really tip the tide.
It was a perfect timing as well. Oh, there on Korea, nearly running in. Banzai nearly got himself brought down as well. But Ferrari, not in ranged form just yet, should not be able to snipe it. Still, what's kind of dangerous, and we have two smoked up supports, Faith as well as Chuan, waiting in the back lines. Chuan not going for concussive shot, actually, going for silence so that Magnus will not be able to skewer across the fissure. And we'll see if that works out. I think it's going to be tough either way, and they say, yep, it's tough. We fly back and try and get mid, try and get top. Mag is a little bit far out away from his tower, but he should be fine, I think. And now they walk back under the Observer. So Mac as well as Resolution should be well aware of this upcoming gank.
I think the intention was good for IG support, so like, man, Ferrari just lost his bottle mid, we have to go and try and bail him out if we possibly can, bring the lane back to even, but unfortunately Creepwave not in a great position as they make their way in, and they were missing long enough that it probably started to get a bit suspicious, and Mag was calling missing, so IG support just gonna have to go back to farming up a little bit, and IG, I think, not moving as fast as they would like so far this game, but they're still doing alright. Lua's got some pretty good farm. FaZe boots up for him, and expecting just to see an early mech from this point forward. Aww.
Mech doing the cheeky plays, just hiding in the trees there. Now he's gonna jump right out, he knows what's up, and says, oh no, I'm not staying here any longer. Gets out of there. Ferrari had to go back to base due to his lack of drinks. He will have to return to the base for healing, so ES stood in for a while, got some EXP, much needed going for that level 3. 2 in the Fissure, no point in Enchant Totem as we saw earlier on, but now DK getting caught out, a Soul Catcher doesn't land, let's go to Skewer, hitting him right on the mark there, body blocking mid, RP under the tower, this will be Ferrari giving up first blood, I think Eidolons, do they get him too slow? And Chuan might get the return first blood. Great bailout here from the ES. Always want to fly. Try to do that Eidolon extended reach. Nearly got him, but IG managed not to beat up first blood. And that was RP going down as well. Ferrari gonna be tanking his supports for their quick reactions.
Yeah, I think Empire just thought that was a guaranteed kill, but IG showing that they definitely can defy expectations, and that was a lot invested for Empire. They've done everything that they can to really give Ferrari a hard time on mid lane, and he keeps on bouncing back. And support's also setting up a little stack for him a little bit later on, so I think he's still going to be just fine.
Yeah, and whatever the case, it's 2 minutes in, and Empire haven't lost a lot of ground. They're silent is top of the CS chart. It's Razor just tailing a little bit behind, but still, they haven't gotten any pressure on them. They've been applying the pressure themselves. Sniping the courier really crimped the momentum in IG, I think. And Empire, they seem to be getting out of this, weathering the early game storm. But it's still too early to say.
Yeah, IG support duo just hasn't really been able to do a whole lot, and Empire kind of getting away with the greed, having this jungle Enigma who always want to fly. Actually has another Invisor in here.
Oh, Mag might be first blood. There is an Arcane Bolt in 1 second. Doesn't get it. YYM comes in there. There's a Sprout. Mag says chompy chomp. Gets out of there. No Sprout is going to hold him. And YYM summons 3 Trints. And if they don't get a kill, at least they take first blood in towers. For this game, Ferrari rotating in with his Green Dragon. And already beginning to chip on this tier 1. So no saving this tower. They might even go for 2. Oh, they might want to fight this. Dire Structures are fortified. They are grouping up. Maybe buying some time for the Eidolons to take down this tower, but Faith drops a Fissure, but the aggro of the tower has been transferred, so Empire will trade 1-for-1 in terms of towers, and still no kills on the board.
Bottom tower has fallen.
And for the team that is decidedly not the pushing lineup, Empire, I think taking a trade at this stage of the game, they're still going to be very happy.
It's a Magnus Factor.
Yeah,
I think Shockwave is just such an amazingly good skill that... Oh. It's very hard to complain. It's 90 mana, 300 damage in a straight line with 7 seconds of cooldown. It's just pretty good.
Yeah, crazy efficient. Great farming, great counter push.
I love getting it as Rubick. That's one of the best things ever. Yeah, but Luo, he's only got face boots. Does he have anything else flying out? Yeah, a whole lot of stuff. And he does have his mech complete, so Luo looks kind of poor on paper, but actually has a lot of stuff on the courier. That has been killed. And oh boy, we missed it. I missed it. Silent actually getting a solo kill on an Earthshaker. Oh well. It was a good arrow, and with 4 points in Starstorm, you get that double drop. Easy to pick up in underlevel support. And, well, Empire. Striking hard, striking fast. YYF! Oh, might have to be careful here. Taking some tower shots. And YYF actually taking the return poke here on... to Silent. I think Silent might want to go for this. He does have leap. He takes more tower aggro. I think without the tower aggro, he might have actually gotten a kill on YYF. This will be really easy actually. A leap, Starstorm, few right clicks in, you should have brought him down.
Luo poking his head around in the trees looking for Mag, but he's actually on the opposite side this time around, so he's going to be okay to continue trying to soak up some experience.
Get that Chronosphere.
And Empire is just, I think they're very, very happy with how things are playing out. They've almost got their own mech up on Always Wanna Fly, so even not even too much of an advantage there for IG, and they do end up popping a Moonlight Shadow. Looks like they're gonna try and spot something out, though. Looks like not
it's
really
gonna
happen.
It's gonna be difficult. They are looking towards Roshan, but I don't think it's anything they could capitalize on at this point, but Silent? He's still doing pretty good. 1-0-0, first blood on him is always nice. What's flying in on the courier? It will be a full drums, 9 minutes in. So pretty stacked on his Murano. Ring of Aquila, face boots, and drums. 70 CS, 5,300 net worth. Silent doing a great job, and Luo actually falling behind.
Yeah, I'm a little bit surprised that he's also gone for the bottle. Personally, I don't like Muranos that pad out their inventory too much in the early game, because I'd really like to see a Maelstrom up and I'd really like to see some split push out of Silent this game, but he's probably still going to be able to go for it. It'll just be a touch more delayed, and he wants to have that early game impact secure, so I can definitely still agree with that.
But IG are wrapping around. They could find some big kills here. We'll have to see if they find it. Silent walking right into Ferrari. They see him immediately going in for the banish. Are they going for it? Disruption? Nope. Shut them up. Vanskor will be shut up. And Silent going for a very, very optimistic TP there, which Vanskor might achieve. And he will. So, carry for support life. In that case, Magnus picks up the haste runes to make the plays come later on in the match. Attack. But Resolution, he's still saving up for his Blink Dagger. They lose to Murana. There's going to be a TP support in from Always Want to Fly. Combat's one of the triads, but now he gets Concussive shot up. There's going to be Plasma Field with the Silence on him. Easy pickoff. Enigma, not a good TP in.
Always Want to Fly seems to have a couple of these moments a game where he's not quite on the same page as his team in defending a tower. Everybody else seemed to be everybody else was like, okay, tower's dead. We're just gonna go do our own thing. Always Want to Fly is always the ever eager tower defender, but sometimes it doesn't work out.
We had a nickname for him that day. Not gonna repeat it. I know I might get some haters, but you know, he does get caught out of position from time to time, but he does have good plays to make up for them, so we shall see.
Hand of Midas up on the Nature's Prophet, so YYF still going a little bit more old school. I like this, honestly.
Not heavy tradition. New stuff, I mean.
Option mid lane option.
Well, let an RP! Oh ho! 3 heroes in it! And there's your Starstorm as well with the Shockwave. The burst is real. And Ferrari in trouble as the Raging Magnus comes in. Chronosphere traps in his own R carry. What are you doing, Mag? But they lock out Luo and they black hole him. They drop all the big ultimates here. Starstorm nearly landing there. They still got hate on that Magnus. Ferrari came in here to the wrong party. And now IG suddenly find themselves on the back foot as they lose this tier 1 tower along with a couple of their callers. But all three ultimate expanded for these fights, and Empire, they have the huge wombo combos, and that was a huge second RP from Resolution.
Yeah, and now all they need to be careful about is what happens on the backswing. Now that all of the ultimates are on cooldown, they just need to go and get the lanes out as far as they possibly can, establish the map control, and wait for the IG push. IG are going to get quite a bit out of the next couple of minutes. I mean, I'm almost guaranteed, just because those ulties are on CD, and looks like the first point of call is going to be straight into Roshan.
Yeah. Ultimate's down, Roshan time. And we'll see if IG are successful in pulling this off. They most likely will be. IG are not the kind of team to be phased out so easily. They are gonna capitalize as much as possible, try and tip the scales back in their favor. And so far, Empire is still leading that worth, first two in their favor. So IG look unmovable, but they have this very, very good big. Well, they have this knack for coming back into the game, so we'll have to see.
This Roshan is taking a really long time for IG. I think a little bit longer than they were expecting, but they will still be able to bring it down, it seems.
They might contest this now. Oh, Arrow, his Chuan! Chuan loses half his health! This is a farmed Murana. Goodbye, Chuan. They lose their support player. And I think he was just there snoozing on guard duty, and he will lose his life as a result. Luo, they will pick up the Aegis of Immortal, and surprisingly, Empire did not capitalize on this time given for them to take down tier 1, which they will now. There is a no glyph on IG, so that's gonna be a tier 1 for them, but I think they could push a little bit faster.
And now the question becomes, how much IG are going to get out of this Aegis? They have passed it over to the Razor, who's not a bad Aegis carrier by any means, but it looks like that's all they're gonna get for the ultimates coming back up, well, back off cooldown on Empire.
Meta's
complete.
Ferrari, getting caught out. More arrow on him. Starstorm as well. Oh, no Starstorm. The Fissure once again building out this Dragonite, and he will actually run away in time. But nope, Magnus, or Mag, actually says no, stops him in time. Cleans him up with a few cute bashes, and now a Resolution once again lands a good RP. The arrow will hit on Luo, but yes, he does have his Aegis of Immortal. I don't think they want to fight this. He does get dropped down really low, pops the mag, survives, and Silent is going to leap away now. It's a sad thing that Magnus didn't have enough to RP and skewer, but there was a silence from Chuan anyway, so there was no way he was getting that RP anywhere else. And 1-for-1, DK for Magnus. 7-3, IG still on the back foot. At least they don't lose their Aegis. And Resolution, pretty big on the money with these big ultimates. Black Hole about to come off cooldown though.
Yeah, Empire playing really aggressively the instant their ultimates came off cooldown, giving no respect to the IG 5-man just looking for pickoffs non-stop. But it's a really nice decision, just don't let IG necessarily get in position around the tower and jump them before they're ready.
Score. Might go for the deny. Oh no, he disrupts on Ferrari. That's gonna be a feature. Bails him out. Once again, the arrow on the mark. Ferrari 430. Once again, get hit by the arrow. Skewered over the Fissure from his own ally. And 430, he's gonna be dropping down low. Echo Slam! Faith gonna be stunning up the Void for a little bit. Bigger than it looks, but Vanscore, is he gonna run? Gets whipped on his way out. 223 will be the damage he takes. And they only get, they take one kill for it, one tower. IG successfully siege, and Empire will lose one support hero as a result, but they smoke right afterwards. So Luo as well as Faith, they are looking for a kill here. Chuan, we'll see if they do successfully get this Resolution. Magnus, it's really confusing. Mag and Magnus, so confusing. Oh, they get it. Concussive shot. Is there gonna be a silence? That four stops in, skewers away, blink in, and he will be fine. Plasma Field already spent there. There's an arrow. Oh, he's gonna land on one of the Treants, but there's gonna be a TP out. You're gonna see a Prophet TP. Silent, yeah, he just ports out. There'll be no kill on him. He has a double damage though. Could have turned that around, but in the end, they will just bail out. Lose very little, and the four staff and skewer. Pretty good stuff for escaping.
Yeah, and Empire, well, they've managed to wait out half of the Aegis so far. IG have done a really good job of planting down a couple of wards around the place. Well, now that they've gone for that push, so they're going to continue looking for pickoffs. I don't think they're too worried about how things are playing out right now, but Empire, like you talked about, this, the combos are only going to get stronger as the game goes on, and they continue to just play ultra-aggressive Mag and Resolution one more time on the hunt.
The big cooldowns actually go lower as the levels increase, so it's gonna be pretty big, and it's just RP Ferrari. That's the thing, when you have so many big ultimates, you just use them. And Ferrari might actually get chronoed here, we'll see. I think he's not getting out of this mess. Yep, not getting out of this mess. Forces him up, hits him once, and one more hit. Bash as well, Mag is on a killing spree. And he has 3-0-1 on the offlane Void. Silent, still making some space. He has the Moonlight Shadow, might turn around for an arrow onto YYF, but not gonna try it. Rope of the Magi, so Nature's Prophet going for the Orchid.
I think it's really, really good against all of Empire. Honestly,
oh, Vanscore
finds him.
Is there an arrow? Nah, no. Just a cute little harassment there. YYF getting purged as well. The arrow, oh, they could just leap forward now, and this is not gonna save you, Baba. Skewers him out of the trees, and 9-4, really good. Well timed. Didn't use it right away. Time to slow. Make YYF hesitate for a little bit, and they get him.
Yeah, and IG, everybody struggling a little bit aside from Luo, Radiant's who now needs to get a lot done with this BKB. They need
to that worth now.
Yeah, he's got a lot of farm, and we need to see if he can get enough done with it. His teammates need to kind of find an opportunity to get all the lanes out and then hopefully sit behind him while pushing up to a tower. But we're getting to the point where Empire can successfully split push. They're dealing with the counter pushing really well, and also just finding pickoffs all the while. Some really nice map movement and decision making coming out of them.
Yeah,
Faith. Trying to work through his blink deck.
Oh, we have TP's shot. Right into Mag.
I don't think Mag can get a solo kill at a point like that. But
His Mask of Madness just wore out. He was using it to farm the creep camp. I think otherwise maybe he considers it, but he also doesn't quite know who's just around the corner.
One of the other things about a farmed Mirana is that she gets so many levels that her nukes become so potent in a team fight as well. And if you have so many large disables, you can just destroy a singular target. We saw earlier on the Starstorm Shockwave combo just wiped out the two supports on IG. And now Silent, he has gone for the Yasha. I assume he will be going for Manta to avoid the Skywrath Silence, and Chon been pretty poor this game, getting up the wall. It's only got arcanes on himself, but that's expected from a Skywrath mage. Pretty item independent, although his first ability does scale with intelligence.
Yeah, especially when he's making space for Faith to pick up Farm, who's now completed his point daggers. So
now we talked about this.
Yep.
Void with Empower, just gonna be farming really, really big stacks of ancients. Empire dropping really low. Didn't want to take any risks there, would have been really embarrassing on the international stage, but always want to fly. We're gonna be backing the camera on him. Still hasn't landed any huge holes as of yet, just singular target kills, but better than nothing since they have a lot of ultimates to work with anyway.
And Iden just continue to roll in for Empire. IG seems like they're just maybe waiting around for the BKB on Ferrari, but that is going to give time for the Aegis to expire. So that's down for Luo. And YYF still going to take another couple of minutes to finish farming up this Orchid, so we'll see. Maybe that's when IG can start moving around a little bit. They do, of course, have this ES Blink to exploit as well.
Yeah.
They jump in bottom lane.
Well, I'm not sure it was worth killing Enigma just for that, and Skywrath gives out one of his best laughs in the game. But yeah, Faith shows the Blink Dagger there, and as a result, they will not be taking any smashing team fights in the back of that. Oh, Disruption goes out. There we have some trouble. Vanscore getting some trouble, but there's an arrow actually landing on Chuan instead. But Mag drops the Chronosphere onto him, so Skywrath Mage out of the fight, out of the count. But Enigma and Shadow Demon are out, so they will not press this issue here. They will trade one for one in that fight and get away with it. Magnus not anywhere close for that fight. Going for the BKB, I like this build. Will prevent them from getting hit by Dragon Tail as well as Skywrath, as well as the Fissure. So, a lot of things to be careful about. Nope, IG Faith jumps forward. There's a lot of chain stun going on here. Resolution dropping low. He forces away. There is going to be a skewer. Will he get out in time? 2-1 second. Oh, there is the Dragon Knight DOT. Will he find it in time? There's a blink forward. Faith makes the plays. And we'll smack the Magnus into the water. And well, 10 and 7, IG looking to bring it back slowly but surely. They're still 5,000 gold behind, 5,000 EXP behind. But the net worth now back to Silent on the top.
Yeah, IG certainly finding their feet now with the pickoffs. And well, Empire needs to be a little bit careful. Vanscore gets caught out.
Oh, arrow. Vanscore getting caught out, but he will get brought down. The Starstorm coming up from Silent, he dodges the Fission, not so. Now he's gonna try and TP away, there'll be no stuns. Yeah, Faith a little bit short on that blink, so he'll immediately pour out. Not gonna risk any kind of follow-up attack. But this does make space. They are fighting away from Empire Towers. So IG, they're taking these fights, they're getting some small advantages here and there, but they cannot follow it up with tower kills.
Yeah, but IG did get a lot of farm out of the last couple of minutes. Ferrari definitely making a recovery. BKB another 1k gold up for him. We do now see the Maelstrom coming out of Silent. I think a little bit later than I would have liked to have seen it this game. But I can appreciate going for the Yasha. He was moving around a lot and looking for some early kills.
I thought it would be a
Personally, I'm not a fan really of going for the super early Manta. I think you can make an argument for it this game because there are going to be multiple silences, both at the Orchid on the Nature's Prophet and the Skywrath Mage, but I think he can afford to go back for the Maelstrom, and it does speed up his farming pretty substantially.
Oh, always want to fly. He is nearly completing his VKB, and as a result, I wonder how useful this Orchid Malevolence will be. I mean, you'll be good at locking down Mirana, but that's about it. Silent, gonna spot out the rush pit. Either no one's in there, so no need for any panics for now. Mac, working towards his own BKB as well, has gone for the Maelstrom, not gone for Aghanim Scepter, don't really need it at this point. And Resolution, gonna smoke up Shadow Demon and Enigma, looking for pickoffs.
I mean, so much of the pace of this game is just being dictated by successful smoke ganks. Empire had a whole bunch of them in the early to mid game, really set the tone. IG farmed up a couple of items, took some smoke ganks of their own, flipped things sort of back to even, and now we're just going to wait to see who outmaneuvers the other in these upcoming skirmishes, as IG get feeling really suspicious since there's nobody on Empire on the map. They're going to go sit all the way under one of their tier 3 towers and now go for a counter smoke.
Well, it's a really optimistic smoke, to be honest. They smoked really near their base.
At the very worst, they know that Roshan has respawned. They scattered it with a Tran.
Yeah, they got it. Maybe they smoke in? Yeah, they smoke in. They go into the rush pit right now. Chuan might take another arrow on guard duty. Maybe he'll stay awake this time. But IG might sneak another one. They might pull a fast one here on Empire. Our Empire gonna out in time because IG have one of the slowest rush. One of the slowest rush lineups ever, and now they'll just back out. Not spotted out by the Observer just yet, but I think a Sentry spotted it out. Shockwave doesn't reveal, so just throwing it in there to scare them. But the arrow will scout it out, and Empire will realize that, hey, Rosh took a little bit of damage, so they know.
And YYF gonna try and drag them away by heading up top lane. Still a lot of really intricate maneuvering and positioning going on the map right now. Both teams really afraid of the pickoff potential of the opposite team as well. We've got quite a bit of hand-holding going on, and we'll see which is the first team to break away.
We'll see if there are any big faith echo slams. Mag, he is getting closer to his BKB. I think that's why Empire are in no rush right now. They just want to get their BKBs and then just cause a wreckage. I mean, with a bunch of BKBs, IG can do nothing with their fissures, even their wrath of nature. That little bit of extra burst can only go towards the supports like Vanskor, and it's gonna be tough. It's an uphill battle here for IG at this point, and it'll be up to their really, really strong positioning and execution to pull it off. They've done it! Titan put them in a rough spot a few games back, and they showed them how it was done. But Empire did ban out a lot of IG's good heroes though, so might be IG's falling.
I think Empire definitely came into this match really well prepared, and you were just talking about how strong the BKBs are going to be for Empire against this IG lineup. Skyrat's going to do nothing, Nature's Prophet, a lot of his damage is still magical in the Wrath of Nature, and even Dragonite, who has a little bit of right click at this point, is still really reliant on just spamming Dragon Tail and Breathe Fire for his teamfight utility. So Lua's gonna have to step it up. They need to make sure that they get a good static link out of the Razor, otherwise I'm really worried for IG in taking a large-scale engagement.
Yeah, unless you want Ferrari to farm up something really big. He does go for the Shadow Blade, so looking for the pickoffs.
Yeah,
it's gonna be their main thing. With Ferrari Dragonite sneaking in and a Prophet follow up, you can technically get pickoffs pretty easily. But Mag, very close to Blink Dagger. The Faceless Void has a BKB. And oh, there we go! Big RP lands on two of the supports. Immediately catches that Plasma View. Coming in, Yaku Slam from Fame. A BKB only on the Earthshaker though. Ferrari now caught in that Chronosphere. And he is some big ass dragon, gonna get blown up here. Empire Silent is shooting him down. Always wanna fly, getting stepped up here by Luo. Silent really low, Plasma Q catches him out. Dominating for Luo, the hard carry here for IG. But they have already lost four. Mag looking to turn this around, maybe not. Maybe yes, Luo, the only survivor on his team. Resolution buffs up the Faceless Void, and they will not push the issue. So it's a 2-for-4 trade here. IG losing big
Radiant's
in that fight.
Middle tower is under attack.
Again, just really nice teamfight coordination from Empire, great RP from Resolution, and IG, they came so close. Ferrari scouted out all of that, but he couldn't actually do anything to stop them, and as soon as he revealed himself, he just got latched onto by Mag and brought down. Have to say, the Dragon Form looked really impressive in that Chronosphere. That was quite a moment.
He just did nothing that fight.
Yeah, he didn't get out of the
10 second BKB charge and just died. Not his fault anyway. And I mean, that really showed the power of these teamfight ultimates. I mean, when Enigma can just blow a solo black hole on an Earthshaker like that just to keep him out of the fight, you know you are in a lot of trouble. 14 and 11, IG trying to take Roshan for the third time in a row. Maybe they'll be successful this time.
I mean, they'll get it, but we're only 20 seconds away from both the RP and the Chronosphere being back up and ready to go. And the Enigma doesn't even necessarily need Black Hole. If he's just throwing down Midnight Pulse on both of those other disabling ults, then I think he's doing just fine for his contribution to these fights. So we'll have to see what IG are going to be able to get out of this. And looks like Luo are going to be finding his Aegis one more time.
So they have two lives and they have Aghanims on Razor. That's how he got his couple of kills here. He's 5-1, so I wouldn't attribute this game to him, as IG's seems to be slipping up a little bit. But Faith, he's 1-3-9, Nuor trying to carry the Razor. I mean, Razor is never gonna ever be that super hot carry you see in a Faceless Void Spectre, but he's really good at anti-carrying, but he's not too good when it comes to killing. And now YYF gets Chronosphere, and the arrow will secure his death, smacks him down, Magus unstoppable. They're going for Vanskor. They sap Vanskor, but really, when you set Vanskor, you just reduce the damage of the Shadow Demon. The strength of Razor is to actually reduce the damage of the hard carry as well as buff his own. So this way, you're only getting one of the benefits here. You set a support, sure, but the support's not really gonna right-click you. And I don't know, if Luo gets caught in any of these big ultimates, he still goes down pretty easy. So Mag, as well as the Faceless Void, is just looking pretty scary right now. The Empower does give him like an item's worth of damage, I think. So it's a good combo. It's always something to be feared. And Magnus has fallen out of favor a little bit, but a few of these CIS teams still like to run him, and Empire are one of them.
Yeah, and I think while things are looking difficult for IG, you also have to keep in mind at this point that team fights could still go either way. It's going to be more difficult for IG. They have to find the right kind of opening, and now we've got a minor jump in on YYF, but Mag's going to end up being silenced. So
he doesn't have Chrono anyway.
Looks like YYF's going to be okay. But yeah, all that IG needs to do is, they can definitely still out-execute Empire in these fights, disabling Blink Daggers, finding the right initiations with their disables. You could even see Faith jump in and win a team fight all by himself, you know, preventing some big Empire ult. So, still definitely a tense back and forth for both of these two teams.
Yep, and the thing about Empire is their big ultimates, if the only way that IG can successfully say we came out of that ahead is if they trade really unevenly, they win the fight by a big margin. Otherwise, if they lose like 3 heroes and trade for 3 heroes for all the ultimates, by the time they revive in this stage of the game, most of the ultimates will be back up and they can't transition that into a push. So this way, Empire kind of gets multiple chances at trying to break the IG formation. And unless IG pulls out a trade and then buyback without Empire having buybacks, they might be in a little bit of a sticky situation, unless Prophet wants to just go enter full rat mode in this case. It's gonna be scary though, as Weaver Faces Void is very difficult to split push as a Prophet.
Yeah, the Blink Dagger is definitely gonna help, and I like the pickoff. I like the pickup this game. To be able to look for pickoffs, blink out of the trees, silence somebody up, get the sprout, have somebody else on IG make their way in. And Empire, the lanes are in an okay position for them to be going for the smoke, but they need to be careful not to take a team fight while Silence is pinned all the way over on the top side.
Oh, Ferrari. Oh, Ferrari. Oh, now he gets caught, but there is going to be a RP as well as the skewer back in there, and somehow they will have to gem on resolution. So Shadowblade or not, I think Shadowblade was still a very questionable decision, to be honest. It gets countered up very, very easily, especially since Ferrari didn't have a good early game. When he picked up their Shadowblade, Empire were more than in position to pick up a gem to counter him. So he wasted a lot of money on a 3000 item. And at this point, I think Empire just wants to do that reverse death ball. You out death ball IG. I think that seems to be the way to beat this team.
Should just be able to continue pushing him down bottom lane. Luo needs to be, I think, a little bit more careful. He does have his tier 2 at his back, but Without the Dragon Knight alive, they don't really want to be threatening any kind of fight here.
Yeah, I'll still say this game's pretty even though, despite all the mishaps IG has had. It's
I wouldn't say even, but like we were saying, IG could still definitely
anyone's
take this
game.
Take this game. Yeah. Yeah.
But it should be more in Empire's favor, since they do have that constant 5,000 on their gold XP charts. Maybe Faith drops a big one.
We shall have to keep an eye out. And Mag getting a ton of farm, already has his BKB, another 3.6k gold up for the Faceless Void, so things are looking good there.
And once Enigma gets a dagger, that's even worse.
Yeah.
They don't have anything to cancel Black Hole BKB, so they're just gonna be stuck around doing nothing, floating the air, whether or not in a chrono, in a RP, or in a black hole. This started off looking like a bad draft, but they held on and they pulled it off. We were doubting that Havoc sniper game as well, so a lot of teams just feel, oh man, right on top of the observer. And Fade not gonna survive this one, and now there's a BKB as well. You're not killing this guy, and he ports out. It's a freebie. It's not exactly the most worthwhile of kills, but at least they get it, and they're delaying this Aegis, so they can't push without the Earthshaker. Aegis will go in 25 seconds, Void mid space, and they still have two big team fight ultimates up. IG, 15,000 viewers, man, looking at them play, and these fans could very well be on their way to lose some rares.
Yeah, IG just getting picked to pieces. Empire playing some really nice Dota right now, and even just looking towards this tier 2 tower on top lane, looks like Sound's gonna pick it up, no contest. YWF tries to blink in to deal with it, but not gonna happen. And Empire, like you were talking about, all of this aggression and all of these pickoffs have been happening while IG have an Aegis in hand. They've just been really running them around in circles and wasting their time. So
it's a big difference without Shaman.
Yeah, I mean, just but even then, I mean, the Shadow Shaman can split push to an extent, but IG haven't even been given the opportunity to take a fight at this point, and yeah. But I think you're 100% right to point out that Empire with the Shadow Shaman ban have really set themselves up nicely, having seen the strategy that IG were going for. And I think you can also say that IG revealed their hand pretty early on.
It's like, we'll just do the same thing that's been working all well. And they got out Deathball. I think this is the first time Void, Magnus, and a Black Hole Enigma has been picked in the same draft. So, and how many Treants has it been converted in this game? I don't know. It's been a lot, actually. Oh, there's your Chronosphere once again. Ferrari really getting caught out a lot in this game. Monster kill for the offlane Void. 8 and 0. That's a fade. There, Silas taking a lot of damage, goes into the BKB. Will he get out of there in time? Yes, the Moonlight Shadow will keep him alive. Vascore will nearly die here, but no, here comes the Black Hole. Always want to fly, catches two of them in it, and follow that with the RP. The Wombo combo is real. IG getting picked to pieces. YYF, the only guy left, he's gonna run away. The disruption will save Vanskor's life from that fissure. They are all blinking after him. YYF, the Prophet, scrambling for safety. Magnus, Mag comes in here, smacks him down beyond godlike on the offlane, a 10-10-0 on that Faceless Void. Amazing, amazing execution here for Empire. One after another. IG spend their entire teamfight stunned. So, I don't know, we talked about this. Overlapping stuns fallen over and over. And Ferrari just getting caught out. Should not have been there. I mean, Observer Wards at this point in time on this spot is pretty obvious.
Yeah, I mean, it doesn't really matter if you're... No. It doesn't matter if you're the best team in the world if you just spend every single fight chain stunned to death.
Yeah, I mean, stuns are good stuff. And, oh, Vanskor getting caught up. BKB on 430. That might have died a little bit far. No, sir! Mag actually gets that kill. Might actually get drawn as well. Why not? 2-for-1 special right here. Mag just rolling faces, taking nades. And Vanskor still alive with the push juice. They actually will get him. The Dragon Breath tries to get him there. The skewer forward will catch him at 430. Now he's the one hunted. He's gonna be brought down. Shadow Poison nearly tags him at the end there. Always wanna fly TPs out. Vanskor falls off to the high ground. And YYF with the blink, not enough to finish up the kill. Empire blink out of their minds. No team is gonna be left unaccounted for in this international, it would seem. Amazing.
Yeah, just crazy play
from
Empire.
How did these guys at 2-6?
Yeah.
What?
Like, what are we... What are we watching right now? This is ridiculous. And Mag, I mean, what a performance. 12-0-4
easy on his face life. Oh, here comes the Mirror. He's gonna jump in. Luo's about to take it deep, and he will. Smack, 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 smack. Maybe not killing him this time. Late mill on him. Nope, he's taking a lot of damage, and he will go down to bash. Finishes him off. He's now 13-0. These off laners are just really racking up this international resolution. His Magnus is not to be shot as well. He's been doing a lot of work with his RPs. I think I don't see a single one bad. Oh, Tron getting bash, bash, bash! Brought down 14-0. The Sprout panicking there on the Sprout. Resolution throws an RP because why not? You're running out of heroes anyway. We just throw it on top. 26-13, double the kill score against IG. I'm not surprised if IG taps off anytime soon.
So Empire's carry, in air quotes, is on the sidelines at the moment, but Mag is still just marching triumphantly forward into the IG base, and I don't know what they have left at the moment.
I don't know. They'll lose Rex at the very least. They'll probably lose Rex here. They might try and fight this. They might get blown out because 3 seconds later, there will be a Chronos here. And Ferrari, you might be on the wrong side of town, buddy. And you go. You see Mag running at you. You see it. You see it. And there's your chain stun. That's going to be coming out. No need for that, actually. Just the Soul Catcher. They just beat him up. And Mag, not even looking at him, just walks past him. I don't even need to finish you. I'll give that to my support. Earthshaker is back. That could be a dunk. Nope, 55 seconds for that. So they lose Rex. IG looking to be on the rocks for this game. Keys are about to be lost. DKB here on Mag. He wants to go back in. Now he's damage getting stabbed out. So I think it's time to leave. Fun's over, Mag. Time to run. 84 damage out. And he'll be 4-star forward. And well, IG, they blow up their BKB on their carry. And lose mid Rex. Faith, what's he going to go for? No, he doesn't have gold because he bought back into the game. So RIF, I think, was looking for a snipe. The Wrath of Nature will come out, and they realize that there will be an Observer Ward somewhere here and decide to uncamp that spot.
So, actually going to go for another Roshan here, but I feel like Aegis has been by far the least useful item for them this entire game long. They have
Shadow Blade against Chronosphere.
Yeah, they haven't got value out of it a single time, and I don't think this time's going to be any different.
This time it's about to get real bad. Double damage from the Void. He jumps in. Okay, IG are done. Luo getting pounded down. The BKB does remove the double damage though. Vanskor steals it, but really, he buys back into the game. I don't think he'll be back in here to contest. The arrow flies across the tree line. Oh, nearly hits Fade. There'll be a duck here, but no! The RP finds him there with the vision from the arrow. He brings him in, and there's Mag just killing off the Mjolnir Lightning Frog. Back to the fight here. Silent pops his BKB, fights his Luo. Luo drains his damage, gets more by Black Hole. Catches Ferrari, catches Luo. I think GG is about round the corner. He tries to land his sword, gets brought down by the bash, and YYF. We'll see the last death of the game. Chuan, the only one to survive, or will he? 10 seconds to go, will he be safe by the throne? IG called GG, and yeah, I think he will survive. Yeah, he will. GG well played from Vanskor, and very well played indeed. Once again, who the hell are these guys? How are they in 2 and 6? IG getting massacred in that.
Bottom 3 taking games off of top 3.
Oh man, this is the best international ever.
The group stage is absolutely wild. And well, there you go. We thought that we had a really clear picture of how the group stage was shaping up as we move past the halfway point and we get towards the end of day 2, but